how many of you have been or is addicted to video games? Thank you to those who kindly admitted, because honestly, we're all addicted to something, legal or not. So, in today's society, everyone is so glued to their electronic devices. I can't even go to a family gathering without having to see my cousins constantly playing on their tablets. Everyone is getting so sucked into these virtual universes that's slowly hurting our lives, and we don't even know it. I am part of the gaming society, and my name is Julina, and I'm a victim to video game addiction. So learning about the pros and cons of playing will help us give a better understanding of what it really means to be addicted. First, I'll explore the benefits, and then I'll explain the types of this addiction and how it grows, and lastly, the outcomes if this were to worsen. So first off, video games aren't all that bad. Has a parent ever told you that they'll rot your brain? Well, they aren't partially correct, because we can learn a lot from video games, and it could be very beneficial to us in our everyday lives. On February 8, 2012, Utah Valley Pediatrics stated, students have found that video games improve students' ability to learn, increases brain activity when it comes to making fast decisions, quick reflexes, and learning how to be a team player. Video games like Street Fighter and Super Smash Bros. Are excellent examples, because they're not just about smashing buttons, they're also about strategic planning if you want to come out as the winner. Also, whether it's in a game or in a group project, you must learn about your team's, both your teammates' strengths and weaknesses if you want to take out the full potential of your group, if you want to come out as top. In life, it gets really boring, and it gets really tiring, and we just want a break. And we want to do nothing more than play a game that's just relaxed entertainment. Meaning there's no monsters, no brain puzzles, nothing like that, just relaxed entertainment about you. Some games like that are Harvest Moon, Animal Crossing, and Minecraft. They may look boring to the outside people who don't play video games, but actually they are quite entertaining to any type of audience, because all it does is it involves you, and you could come back and return to these worlds with nothing changing. So now that we know the pros of gaming, let's now talk about the addiction, the two types of addiction, and what causes them. In the article Video Game Addiction and Symptoms, Cause, and Effects by PsychGuides.com, there are two types of addiction, the first being online and the second being standard. So online games are usually played with others from all around the world. We can interact with our friends in the comfort of our own homes. Games like these are MapleStory, World of Warcraft, and yes, even Club Penguin can be a problem if you constantly are on this every single day. You get to be sociable without the real life socializing, meaning you could be in your pajamas all day, you don't have to go through the effort of going out, and still you could be with your friends hunting monsters. That's so great, right? But the problem comes when the question arises, when was the last time you left your home? So, okay, I'm gonna be honest with all of you. The moment we got out of this class today, I'm going home. I'm gonna go turn on my Xbox and I'm gonna go finish my game of Final Fantasy 13. And for those who are not familiar with this franchise, these games will take a lot and a lot of your sweet time. Some other games like these are Kingdom Hearts, Super Mario, and Resident Evil. Anyways, these types of games are addictive because they have some sort of motive to keep going. Whether it's the interesting storylines, the characters, the new missions, whatever, these games are created for you to keep wanting more and more. And that results to exceeding our limits and even our money. I have a save file that has over 80 hours spent playing, and that's only one save file from one game, from a series with over 10 installments. Like, that's about 800 hours of my life taken away from just a small portion of my game collection. So now that we know the types of addiction and how they grow, let's now explore the effects that these were to worsen. When I play, I don't mean going off for an hour and then going back to responsibilities. No, I mean going on for 3 to 6 hours a day straight, skipping meals in order just to play more. This is very unhealthy, and this could lead to a poor diet and sleeping disorders. Also, these could lead to poor hygiene, back pain, and severe headaches. It can't just hurt us physically, but it can also hurt us emotionally. Stated by Unity Point Health, research found that 1 in 10 gamers from ages 8 to 18 are compulsive gamers or addicted to video games. This leads us to risking our friends, our families, and our significant others, and could lead to a world of loneliness. It's also connected to stress, anxiety, and depression as well. So now that you know the pros and cons to gaming, hopefully it gave you a better understanding of what it really means to be addicted. First, I talked about the pros and the benefits, and then I talked about the two types and also how they expand, and lastly, the outcomes if you were to become addicted. Don't get me wrong, I love video games. Video games are a great way to pass the time if you just want a relaxation from life or just to hang out with your friends. But just know that too much of a good thing can become